This struggle has been there for a very long time, for some time now, moving on and fighting all manner of battles. But before I go on, let me just refresh our mind. Those who have been there for some time will understand. Those who have not been there, you can learn one or two things so that it will help you not to jump around. It will help you to know how. I remember as at 2012, 2013, when the struggle kicked off, we are there as some of the oldest people who kick this struggle off, and we continue to move on. A lot of temptation are coming, but there are people who remain resolute. I want just to talk on Radio Biafra. You may not know, the attack has started coming left and right. That is why we must always thank God for our leader. When he started, nobody was in his support. Nobody was in his support, even his own deputy then. When our leader will preach something, most especially when it comes to religious things, things that are spiritual, you know that indeed this thing is coming from revelation. It is God that given. It's not everybody that has the gift to understand the spiritual thing. There are spiritual things before you understand this. Somebody have to receive it. Somebody interpret it. Then you, a pure carnal man, can do what? Can now understand that. That is how it is. When you don't have the grace for all those things, all you need is just to listen. That is why sometimes we have spiritual somebody, spiritual this, spiritual that. That will help you. That time our leader will come and preach everything. The next thing you see is the deputy will come and counter it. A pure carnal man, who knows nothing, who just sit and be eating food. This is his deputy then, but our leader continued to move on, to press on. Now, come to other political things. I remember the attack with Bilie then. We are working hand in hand with Bilie Human Rights Initiative then that is dead. Or whatever our leader calls his cause, you must know that. These people at a certain time, they rise up. When the head of the Bilie or whatever movement they call themselves, we are working with Rochas Okorocha. This president Rochas Okorocha, Rochas Okorocha promised them then. I'm telling you because I'm a student of history of this movement. Rochas Okorocha promised them that they would do Biafra together, everything. And this belief followed them. They gave them, was it 5 million or whatever then? It was mentioned on Radio Biafra at that time. They will give them money. So they start pushing this Radio Biafra under the leadership of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu to succumb to them. Our leader still stand firm. Although in that battle, the deputy was there to fight against, then push out this belief, and they were caused. At the end of the day, that was it. I remember one broadcast our leader made, he called it Amagedon. I think that was on September 2013, thereabout. It was September, within that time. He made that broadcast. It was Amagedon. He was in Nigeria then. That time still working with, you know, the saga between Rita Nimbogo, Ikechukwu Enyeag, them and whatever. Then in 2014, this was their own pop-out. Their own pop-out. We fought the battle. We fight. Still, we are still standing. Our leader defeated them when they brought the issue of transmitter. All these things you are seeing, you must have the understanding so that when you see this thing, somebody like me, I mean, it's nothing to me. We have been seeing it, it has been coming and being defeated. Some of them, you don't even need to talk. You just keep quiet, it will just die off naturally. Muhammad Dike will be where he is. Sometimes he will cause that thing. He will tell you, say, this thing will die. And you watch them. And when it's gone completely, nothing like that. That saga was there, Rita and Dahaku and whatever, Inyago, all those things. Pia, that was the end. Those ones, we didn't see them. There was before then, there was an attack. That time, this movement was stationed in three sections. The editorial board of Radio Biafra, the Supreme Council of the Elders, and the National Executive Council. That was how our leader arranged this thing, thinking that he's working with human, but on the process, there was a kind of collusion to overthrow him, to remove him on that time, but it didn't work. One thing is that when the grace is upon you in anything you are doing, my dear brothers and sisters, you must know that nobody will defeat you. Have that in mind. When God, you know that this thing, God has called you for this job. I'm telling you, nobody can defeat you on that. have that in mind. Our leader fought this battle, he fought it, and he defeated them completely. The National Executive Council, then the editorial board of Radio Biafra, which comprises of our leader Imam Mezu and Mefo, the Supreme Council of Elders, that's also Brodem and Co, and the Leti Kedife and the Co, which we thought that these people are there with us for Biafra. But most of the time, what you see them is politics, just as you see Anambra election now. This is the time you know who is with you, those who are telling you Biafra. All of them will just pop out looking for one. If this person win, I will be given a post of commissioner or this or minister, all those kind of thing. At the end of the day, all of them betrayed. And our leader now understand what Elohim has asked him to do. What happened? He just scraped all those things off. Both the National Executive Council, Supreme Council of the Elders, all those things, he scraped it off. And that is the time he stepped up. Even on the board of editorial board of Radio Biafra, he stepped off to take over completely. Because that time, some certain people within him are vibrating. They are no more who they are. Brother, why I'm saying all this is just to educate you, to strengthen your mind. Very, very important. To strengthen your mind is very, very important. You have this understanding at this time, because if you don't have it, you will be shaken. Listen, there was something that happened, I think, is it in number 13? I'm not too sure. When Moses agreed with the people to go and look into the spy, when they send the spy returned and gave wrong information. When Moses was writing completely his tenor, everything, it was there he uttered the word. I always underline that place whenever I come within the Bible. The people said, God did not ask him to set a committee, listen, but Moses agreed. The people came and suggested to Moses, let us do this, let us tell the spy. But what God said, move on, go. God knows what is there. God knows what is there. Then when the spies go, the issue of going to spy and return back that caused them 40 years in the wilderness was not the will of God. We must understand, this is the will of man. They decided to do this, to do that. That is why the scripture will tell you that there is a thing that seems right to a man, but the end leads to destruction. We must understand that, very, very important. Then when they came, they gave a bad news. Our leader realized that time that he is the chosen one. He is the one God has called and is scrap and stand as the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra completely, taking the decision. And since then, you see that whatever attack that is coming is automatically defeated. Vote on the board. Then we continue to move on. The issue of transformer came in. They said all manner of things, all manner of statements, whatever. And at the end of the day, it was defeated. The transformer came out. Even when they leaked, when it was showed that we are pushing this, that is why I don't succumb. Our DOS must know that they must not succumb to any pressure to come and tell you what they have in mind. The moment they tell you, you will go and tell the DSS. Then that is how our transmitter was taken. The transmitter was pulled out successfully, dropped where it should be. People were talking this, that is not the transmitter, this, that. When they were shown where it is, the next thing we saw it in DSS office. We must understand all these things. Very, very important. That is why don't let people push you in as much as you're under the grace of this movement. Don't push. Don't let anybody push you. Rather, keep on frustrating their thoughts. They want to hear something. They want to, at the end of the day, they will not. They'll get frustrated and die off. That one came and passed. We continue. Even our 30th man came up. We built our cenotaph. Our cenotaph were built that time in Enugu. The head office of this struggle was in Enugu, the capital city. Our leader said it. But when the place was rent and settled there, this same group of people decided to betray and even to hand our leader over to the DSS. That is why our leader left that place and returned to his father's compound, where he has his autonomous right to do whatever he wished to do. as at then. We must understand, because it was in Enugu where we settled then. It was where we find our office. Everything was there as at 2014, before that saga came up. I want to refresh our mind. That is why I'm trying to go through all these things. You will learn one or two things you don't know. For those who join on the road and they don't understand left and right, you go here, you pick information, this, that. It pains me when I have been equipped with all this understanding and somebody who is not up to 2 years or 3 years, even 4 years to come and be pushing me or tell me this, that. I will just hold my anger, but I will not talk to you. Because we have seen all these things. Fight the battle on Facebook. Fight the battle on Facebook. After we defeated the cenotaph was destroyed by Masob. Masobians sent by Wazirike, they destroyed that cenotaph. But we have done what we want to do in the spirit by honoring our dead. And we continue to do it every 30th man. We must understand that. We kick it off. So this thing continued to move on. There are some certain individuals, I did not mention their name before I return back in this. That time on Facebook, there is one guy they call Engineer Zekwasare. He started his own radio Biafra of a thing. That one can write 1 million mail according to our leader every day. Then he will write and post, chatting everybody. At the end of the day, he died off. Nobody knows where that one is today. There's one Emmanuel Nwachukwu in Germany. That one is on Facebook. He will call you on that time. Facebook Live have not started. There's no Facebook Live. He will call you on Facebook call. Then record whatever you do. Then he'll go and put it in his radio. That one died. Radio Biafra stays stand. There is one Radio 24 or 24 Radio. One guy in Spain. They call Monso, whatever is the name of the guy. He opened his own. I'm broadcasting. Every time I'm broadcasting. That one died. It died itself to challenge what God has put by himself. So these are the things. We continue to move. Then come 2015, when our leader was kidnapped in October 14th, I think, 2015, or arrested that time. We call it arrested in Lagos. Problem, something like this just pop out internally, externally, which on the phone with the then DOS, they are fighting everywhere, money, this, that, fighting. Most of us maybe might have joined as a then. What happened? At the end of the day, God used his hand to do his job. We discover who is who. Some of us were ignorant, following some certain people, believing that they are telling us the truth. At the end of the day, God used his hand to filter everything. To filter everything. And listen, there is something you must know in life. That somebody help you does not mean that that person is good. Have this thing in mind. God can use anybody to help you or to do something. Don't go and worship that person. Hey, he did this, he did that. Give glory to God who used that person. It could be a wicked person, but God has struck his mind as at that time to help you, to deliver you. Don't go tomorrow, you bow to that person and say, did this during that time. It could be evil person, but God has used him to save you and allow him to continue with his evil way. I know why I'm saying, because that battle in 2017, 2018, when the other DOS went out, when they were left, and now the deputy is out on his own, don't come and say this one is good and this one is no good. This is why you remove this one. Evil is evil. It's like a seed in your heart. Evil is like a seed in your heart. In as much as it's still there, it will germinate one day. That is one thing I must tell you. But continue with my historical analysis. What happened? This set of DOS were out and they went and opened their own radio. You know, the international something radio, they opened. What happened? They tried gara. At the end of the day, everything is dead completely. But this Radio Biafra, under the leadership of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, is still going on. I'm telling you what grace works, how it works. I'm telling you, it continue. From there, many other radio springs out. Finally, the deputy who claimed that he knows everything, that there is something he will say, and the struggle will die. And we are opening our ear to hear as deputy he is, not knowing that it's just deputy to be receiving salary. Nothing is there. Nothing. It's just empty vessel with his boy. What's his name? Onyibo, whatever, you know. So well, at the end of the day, nothing. They opened their human rights today. We are at there. The strength, the energy to do that thing is not even in them anymore. The enthusiasm is not in them to tell you that the hand of God is not there, the grace of God is not there. Now, our leader had been kidnapped this time. This time is kidnapping, abducted, and extraordinary rendition to the Zoological Republic. You see the devil again springing up. This one is internal. But in as much as we defeat that of 2015 to 2017, and we still stand, and defeat that of the deputy. That of the deputy was just like where one says, "Say, oh, Coco," you know, just an ordinary chicken die. Nobody worries, you know, because that time when it was trying to pop out, people thought that as deputy, he knows this, he knows that, that when it does, so, you know, the thing will come. It's just like Edoma says, "Say, no remote Coco," you know, just. The small chicken that just hatched died. Nobody knows anything. These things, if you watch these things, brother and sister, you will know how God's things are. Still then, Radio Biafra is still popping. People are doing work, doing things, broadcasting. Men on ground are doing their best. People are supporting, contributing money. The human right, whatever nonsense, radio is dead. And can't even broadcast as it was. The energy, the strength in them, and the wisdom is gone. Remember what happened to Ahitofe. Ahitofe was excelling in his wisdom because he was attached to David then. But the moment he decamped from David, that his wisdom is there. The wisdom is there, but it was corrupted. The wisdom was corrupt. So whatever comes out of it is corrupt, and that is how it dies. I'm giving you this brief history for you to understand just the little summary of it, for you to have something in your mind. This one that is doing cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha, somebody like me watching it, it doesn't move me. And that is why I don't talk. If you listen to my broadcast, I don't waste time on all those things. I only tell you, see, detect who the enemy is or are, then focus on the real enemy, the distractions of the enemy internally. Just know them, then know how to move on. I tell you the gospel truth, just know how. The real enemy is the serpent, the ancient serpent, the fallen knees. They are the one engineering all these things, you know, spiritually, physically, spiritually. They can project something into you, mostly like the cow you are eating, desecrated cow you are chopping in suya and whatever. You can eat it and it will change your mind. You are not spiritual strong. Anything can happen to you. You think you are moving, but you are destroying yourself. So they are the real enemy to focus. And that is why I always focus on them. Because when you cut off the head of the serpent, that is the end. It will die. But if you are just hitting it as the head is still there, it will still bite. Very, very important. So this internal one, I am telling you, my dear brother, that this one will also die. Will also die. It will die off completely. When the grace is not there, you can't function. And you don't fight the grace. When you try to fight the grace, you will be disgraced. But when you walk with grace, you will be greased. G-R-E-A-S-E, greased. When you are walking with the grace, the real divine grace, your elbow will be greased. You will be functioning effectively as if you are the best. That is where our people miss it. This man will think that, in fact, if not him, the heaven will fall. The moment he pull out, he become a disgrace. I want you to have this understanding. When you fight the grace, you will be destroyed. You will be disgraced. But when you walk with the grace, you will be greased. Your elbows, your joint will be greased. And you can function effectively, excel beyond your expectation. You must know that. So this is the grace that is there. You know what grease is. Grease that is you use for lubrication. You know what friction works. How something becomes so friction. When there is no grease, you have to lubricate something, then it moves smoothly. just like your car you are driving now, or other substances, and you must apply some grease in it, lubrication, for it to be free and continue to function. That is what I mean. When you walk with that grease, you will be fully greased. Have it in mind that the grace is not from you, but the grace has greased you to move on. So don't make all these mistakes. Enemy can come and they will give you some useless motivational words into your brain. You are nobody, because you are not the chosen one. It's only few chosen ones in a particular thing. In one sect, there's only one Joseph. Everybody cannot be Joseph everywhere. Then the world will not be a sweet place. It's just one Joseph, one Moses, one Joshua at a time. And when that person comes, he has the grace. And when you walk with him, you will be graced. You can function with him very well. Very, very important. You must have that understanding. It's everywhere. So this is just a little summary of what I want to, put our mind into. Just refresh our mind, or lecture some of us who are just new, so that you don't know how this is how it has been happening, coming and going, and the struggle still remain and keep on moving and hitting the zoo very bad. The zoo is dying now. Some people have been ashamed. SMD now are crying, say they will support Biafra if they don't give them 2023. They want to use our struggle. They will return back shamefully. The North are holding the power to the core, telling you that no way for you. You see that what we are doing is very good and wonderful, and the hands of God is there. Follow whom no road, follow whom the Lord has shown the way. That is what I'm trying to let us know. Very, very important. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2, coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London, under the leadership of one and only Onyendu Manze Nnamdi Kanu, Ohamadike, one of Biafra Land. We will now go to our news in details.